On November 1st, China's Ministry of Commerce issued a notice that encouraged the public to stockpile daily necessities in the event of emergencies. The move quickly sparked panic and wild speculation. Some linked the call to stockpile food to the current situation in the Taiwan Strait and started to prepare for war. State-controlled media later denied the war connection. But why did Beijing suddenly ask people to stock up? I think it may have something to do with its massive food imports. Hi everyone, welcome to Lei's Real Talk, I'm Lei. Mainland Chinese media reported that people across the country rushed to buy food. Pictures of people lining up at supermarket checkouts went viral. Videos posted on Chinese social media show long lines of customers at grocery stores with empty store shelves. It was reported that some people bought as much as 600 pounds of rice. But then officials came out to dispel the rumors, asking people not to panic. An official state media, the Economic Daily, issued an article asking people not to overreact or misinterpret the message. Don't be too imaginative, the article said. Despite the effort by officials to dispel rumors, the likelihood of a war against Taiwan is on people's minds, prompting greater confusion and war discussions. Why does Beijing suddenly ask people to stockpile rice, oil, and grains? Is Beijing really preparing for war? A video released by Changsha Evening News in Hunan announced that air defense sirens were tested across the province. The air defense offices in Shandong and Anhui provinces also announced recently that emergency preparedness kits have been distributed to some residents, and that air defense preparedness education has been initiated. Some netizens posted videos showing military vehicles weaving through the streets of Zhejiang as evidence that the CCP was preparing to attack Taiwan. There is no question that Beijing is preparing for war, but is it for an immediate attack? Su Ziyun, a director at Taiwan's National Defense and Security Research Institute, said in an interview with The Epoch Times that the CCP has historically used these tactics, such as testing defense sirens, for internal publicity purposes. They are done to mobilize their domestic audience. But it doesn't mean that it will launch a war right away. He said that if the CCP really wanted to start a war immediately, it wouldn't send warning signals like that ahead of time. Li Zhengxiu, a military expert at Taiwan's National Policy Research Foundation, shared the same view. Li said, "There is no sign yet of the CCP launching an attack on Taiwan. It should be more likely that it's for building internal unity and solidarity." If it's not waging a war in the near future, why does Beijing ask its people to stock up now? I did my research and think I found the reason behind the stockpiling. On November 6, 6 days after the stockpiling notice, China's Grain and Oil Information website published an exclusive article titled, "The Price of Rice Finally Rose." It stated that China's domestic rice market has had an oversupply issue, which drove down the prices. But since the Ministry of Commerce stockpiling notice was published, rice prices have gone up. Despite weak domestic demand and soft prices, China's rice imports this year have doubled. From January to August, total rice imports increased from 1.5 million metric tons last year to 3.2 million metric tons this year, according to data from Chinese Customs. But why does the country double its rice imports when there is an oversupply in the domestic market? Very good question. This is because China's rice importers want to make some quick money. According to S&P Global Platts, the U.S. Department of Agriculture has indicated that the substantial dip in Asian origin rice prices is the reason for the uptick in China's imports. Taking the benchmark Thai white rice as an example, the price dipped from $542 per metric ton in February to $370 per metric ton in August, a drop of almost a third. This is even lower than the recent auction price for old crop paddy by China's National Grain Trade Center, which was at $391 per metric ton. China's rice importers saw a great money-making opportunity because they can buy low from the international market and sell high domestically. But there must be demand for the rice for them to make money. Besides, there's another problem. China has a policy of storing from 4 to 6 months of grain to prepare for situations like natural disasters or wars. However, in the context of an import surge and a dip in domestic prices and demand, the National Grain Trade Center, or NGTC, has not been able to release old crop paddy reserves as fast as it should. For example, in September last year, the NGTC sold 10%, or 1.3 million metric tons of paddy, out of a possible 30 million metric tons. In contrast, this September, NGTC was only able to sell 0.3%, or 23,000 metric tons, out of a 7.2 million. It appears that Beijing is under pressure to find a way to reduce its substantial old crop stock buildup. One of these methods would be to increase exports of the old grain. But that didn't happen, as China's export of rice has remained flat this year. The continued buildup of rice stock in China, as well as the need to sell the imported rice, have pushed Beijing to come up with a solution fast. The Ministry of Commerce stockpiling notice was designed to ease the national old crop reserve overstock, stimulate domestic demand for rice, and ultimately have Chinese citizens foot the bill for China's rice importer, which is basically the government. So essentially, Chinese consumers stockpiled rice and helped their government financially. So now you know what's behind the official stockpiling notice. Other than easing the national grain overstock and help the government make money, it also serves two other purposes: to create publicity to prepare the citizens for war, and to prepare for a possible lockdown in case of a COVID outbreak during the Beijing Winter Olympics. Since October the 17th, mainland China has seen a surge in COVID cases across the country. In 2 weeks, the current outbreak has spread to 20 provinces, including the capital city. A wedding photographer in the Beijing hotel was recently confirmed as having COVID. This hotel is located less than a kilometer or two-thirds of a mile from Zhongnanhai, the CCP leadership compound. The city is on high alert, ready to be shut down in the event of an outbreak during the games. The public panic over food stockpiling made one mainland Chinese netizen leave this comment, which I thought was funny. He said, "The panic over food doesn't feel like we will attack Taiwan. It feels more like we will be attacked by Taiwan." That's all for today. Please check out my videos on why China cut power and the deadliest battle between China and the US during the Korean War. Thank you very much, and I'll see you next time.